Hi everyone, today we're going to use the Texas BA2 Plus financial calculator to solve an amortization problem. Let's look at the example. Zhang is paying $2,000 at the end of every 3 months to settle a loan of $8,000 at 4.5% compounded semi-annually. We have two questions. A, we need to calculate the number of payments required. B, we need to construct an amortization schedule. Let's look at A. We'll draw a timeline. So Zhang has this loan of $8,000. That is the present value, PV. And he's trying to make $2,000 as periodic payment to settle the loan. So we have PMT is $2,000. And the end of the year term, future value would be zero. He would be paying off the loan, so FV is zero. In order to solve this problem, to find how many payments he will need to settle the loan, we will need seven variables. CY, compounding per year. PY, payment per year. And these five buttons on this row. N, IY, PV, PMT and FV. We need to identify all these values. We already know the present value is $8,000. And the future value is zero. Periodic payment, he makes $2,000 end of every 3 months. So it's $2,000. Now, when we use the calculator, we're going to be careful with the sign. So he received $8,000 loan today. That for Zhang is cash inflow. We keep that as positive. But the one he make periodic payment, that's a cash outflow. So we'll put a negative sign there for PMT. And at the end, future value is zero. So the interest for him is 4.5% compounded semi-annually. So 4.5, compounding semi-annually twice a year. Periodic payment happens every 3 months. So there are four times each year. And N is unknown. Now we have all the information. We're ready to use the calculator to solve the N. Let's push on and off button. We'll turn calculator on. Again, because we have PMT involved, make sure your calculator is set at the right mode. The payment happened at the end of every 3 months. So make sure your calculator is at end mode. Let's write it here. If you do need to change it, you go to second, BGN. You can change it through second, enter. And the file case will change it back to end mode. Push second quit to exit the mode. In order to push the value CY at PY, go to second PY. So PY is 4, enter, scroll down, CY is 2, enter. Now exit by pushing second and quit. Interest rate is 4.5, so 4.5, enter, IY. PV is 8,000. 8,000 PV. PMT is 2,000. And make it negative. Zero is for future value. Now we have four values out of five. We can compute the remaining. Compute N. N value is 4.115. I'll only keep three decimals here. And what does that mean? That means for periodic payment, $2,000 every 3 months, Zhang needs to make four full payments of $2,000. And then the last payment would be a partial payment. So he will make five payments. But only the first four payments are $2,000. Now we're done with question A. Let's try to construct amortization schedule. Now we have finished the calculation for A. We calculated the number of payments required. Our N came out to be 4.115. That means four full payment and one partial payment. And this is our amortization schedule looks like. So payment number, we have five payments. We have amount paid, periodic payments. So let's look at this. For the first four payments, John makes $2,000 payments every time. The fifth payment will be a partial payment, less than $2,000. We don't know how much it is yet. And for each payment, we want to know how much of this payment goes into interest, how much goes into principal, and also after each payment, what is the principal balance, also called outstanding balance. Let's use the calculator to do those tasks. Because when we calculate question A, we already have entered all the values, all the information, N, I, Y, P, V, P, M, T, F, V. So now we can jump to second amort. For the first payment, if I want to find the interest portion and principal portion, make sure P1 is 1, 1, enter. Scroll down, P2 is also 1, because I'm talking about only first payment. So P1 and P2 both are 1. Scroll down, you'll see balance. That is the principal balance, also called outstanding balance. $6,089.50. So we round it to 50 cents. Scroll down again, you've seen the principal. You round it to 1910.50. Scroll down again, interest payment is 89.50. From this calculation, as you can see, the sum of these two numbers would be 2,000 because the $2,000 payments, part of it goes to interest and part of it goes to principal portion. So after this payment, John still have outstanding balance, $6,089.50. In order to calculate for second payment, let's scroll down again. You'll see P1. This time P1 is 2. Enter. P2 is also 2. Scroll down again. Balance 4157.63. We rounded the number to 0.3. Scroll down again. Principal is 1931.87. For interest, 68.13. Again, rounded. All these numbers are rounded to two decimals. So that's for second payment, 2,000. Part of it goes to interest payment. Part of it goes to principal payment. And after this payment, John has outstanding balance of $4,157.63. Now for the three, payment number three, same approach. P1 is 3, P2 is 3. Balance is 2204.14. Principal is 1953.49. Interest 46.51. For the fourth payment, we'll do the same thing. So P1 is 4, enter. P2 is also 4. Balance is 228.80. Principal is 1975.34. Interest is $24.66. Now all of those are calculated output. For the fifth payment, because we know it's a partial payment, it's going to be different. And this time, let's look. After the fourth payment, we have outstanding balance of $228.80. This number is what we need to pay in the fifth payment. So the fifth payment, the principal portion should be just cover the outstanding balance after the fourth payment. What is the interest? We don't know. We'll use calculator. So P1 is 5, P2 is 5. We're going to skip the balance, skip the principal, just jump to interest, 2.56. So now this last payment, some goes into interest, some goes into principal, and this should be the sum of these two. So let's add them up. We have 231.36, and that is the last payment. Now, after last payment, the principal balance, the outstanding balance is zero. We paid it off. The last column, we look at total. So total amount paid for Zhang, we can add them up. We will have $8,231.36. Now, you may use your calculator to calculate this interest portion. I'll show you how. You go to P1. P1 is 1 this time. P2 is 5. Because that means from the first payment to the fifth payment, you go to interest directly, you see 231.36. And this one, principal portion, you will know it would be add up be $8,000. So now pay attention, this number is not from calculator, because we know the loan is $8,000, and that's the principal you need to pay back, $8,000. You also see 8,000 plus 231.36 is the total payment John made. And it makes no sense to talk about the total for outstanding balance. Now we solved the problem, we're done. But there are still a few observations I want to point out to you. First, for interest portion, as you go with each payment, the interest portion decreases and more money goes into principal. So although you're making the same payments every time, but less and less being paid for interest and more goes to principal. And also, you know, the total amount paid covers total interest and the total loan amount. All right, that's all for this question. Thank you for watching.